Authors and editors need simple drag and drop media and asset handling. This is a quick overview of the media system in Drupal. First, the media system in Drupal 8 and above is not the same media system that was in Drupal 7 and previous. The current media system is the ongoing work of the media strategic initiative of Drupal. Currently, the media system fundamentally has two purposes, and because it has two purposes, it has two core modules. The first module is called Media, and its job is to represent media as Drupal entities. This module has been in Drupal core as a stable module since 8.4. Be mindful that this new Media module has no relation at all to the old Media module from Drupal 7. They share the same name. I know that could be confusing. The other module is called Media Library. The purpose of the Media Library module is to make media entities reusable to content authors in nice user interface, such as including WYSIWYG integration to easily select from existing media. Recall our list of Drupal content entities from an earlier video. The purpose of the Media module is to define media as a type of content entity. Again, an entity is an item of content data intended to be displayed to site visitors. Media as Drupal entities means that media items have all the superpowers that entities have. They can take fields. They are translatable. They could be versioned. Media items can be themed. They can be moderated with workflows. They work with Drupal's layout system. Media can work with views. All this stuff media items can do. So everything that we've learned so far with content types, you can also do with media. Media items are similar to content nodes in Drupal. Nodes have a content type, and media items have a media type. Here are the types of media that come by default with Drupal media: audio, document, image, remote video, and video. If none of these types suit your use case, you can create custom media types. Note that the type of media you are creating as a content editor determines the content form you are presented with. A classic example are images. An image file is a source of media for image types, so content editors will be presented with a file upload element. A YouTube video is a source of media for remote video types, and so editors will be presented with a text field to input the video URL. A PDF file can be a source of document media types, and as such, editors will be presented with a file upload element, and so on. So, in general, things you can do with content types can be done with media types as well. There are some things, though, that set media types apart. Firstly, they all have what's known as a source. Source is kind of a fancy word for the type of media you're dealing with. Every media type is associated with a source. The other thing to know is that every media item has at least one required field on it, and this field is called the source field. The purpose of the source field is to store the single most important thing there is to know about any given piece of media. So again, for example, if you have a YouTube video, the most important detail is the YouTube URL to the video. Without the URL, the video cannot be displayed. So the source field will be a text field in which you put a URL. With an image, the image file is the most important thing. So you get an image file field as your source field when you create an image media type. The takeaway here is that the most important thing of a media type is the source field, and the type of form element the source field takes varies depending on the sort of media we're dealing with. So let's look at the source field concept as a diagram. With image fields, you have your entity, say an article node, and it has an image field on it. The single node really owns the image. If you want to reuse that same image somewhere else, you'll need to have that image lying around somewhere because you'll need to upload it again on that different node. With the media system, by contrast, the node references the media item, and the media item has the image and owns the image. So any number of nodes or other entities can reference that media. So why is Drupal's media system good? It's good because, for one thing, media can be a lot more than just images. They can be videos, audio files, or anything else that fits your use case. This architecture makes Drupal more powerful, and it makes things more consistent. So no matter whether you're dealing with a video, an image, whatever, it's handled more or less all the same way, and that is good. The media system has all the benefits of entities, making working with media more flexible. Plus, you can reuse media items. You no longer have to upload the same image multiple times to use on multiple nodes, for example. So how do you reuse things? That's what the media library module is for. The media library enables the author-facing UI for selecting and adding media, right from where you're editing your content. This module is quite simple to use. It's also accessible. Now, the media library is customizable to an extent. It has strong opinions about how it should look, but it is built around a view. We haven't learned about views yet, but we will. For now, just know that a view is something that you are allowed to modify and customize to pretty much however you want. And the media library works with the WYSIWYG, so editors can embed media right into content. All these benefits the media library module provides. And that's that. Fantastic. So let us recap. Media are entities, and media entities have a type. Those type have a special field in which to store their important data. Remember that, for example, with content that has an image field, the content item is the thing that owns the image, and the image cannot be reused without re-uploading it. However, with media fields, it's the media system that owns the image, and therefore the content references the media item, thus enabling reusability. It's the media library that enables reusability. This is everything you absolutely need to know about the media system. Coming up, let's put these concepts to use. See you soon.